Brian, go ahead for Matt Painter.
Yeah, hey, Matt, how are you?
Good.
The offensive execution was pretty good. What was working there?
Well, just being opportunistic. You know, we had some things open up in the first half. Some was off penetration. Some was just off kind of getting some, the right bounce on some things and trying to establish Travion again in the first half, or Zach when he comes in, and didn't have a lot of success in that area in the first half. Obviously, in the second half, Travion really got going. But more or less kind of shot preparation too, like being ready to shoot. Like we go back and watch film and, you face good defensive teams, which Michigan State is and obviously Indiana is, but you're not going to get a lot of cracks at it. But when you do, you got to be ready to shoot the ball. And I thought tonight, our guys stepped up and got some openings and had some execution on our sets and made shots, But as we all know, things look better when the ball goes in.
Is Travion starting to get to the point where he's getting closer to what you think he can be one day? You've always spoken very highly about his potential and whatnot. He's playing obviously really well.
He's played really well in the second halves of the last two games. I think the thing that you have to get when you coach a talented player is you don't compare him to other people. You just hold him to their own standard. So you got to have a standard of excellence for each one of your guys. Everybody's got a different ceiling. His ability to rebound, his ability to pass, and then score in the low post, and just keep things simple. When he keeps things simple, he's tough, man. He's tough to deal with. When he tries to get cute and do some other things, he doesn't help his cause. He might make a shot every blue moon that way. But, I thought in the second half, he was in both games, Michigan State and Indiana, he was fantastic.
You weren't getting a whole lot of stops earlier in the second half, and then for 5.5 minutes there, like mid-second half, they didn't get a field goal. Did anything change defensively in terms of their focus, in terms of anything Indiana was doing, whatever it might have been?
Not really. I thought Indiana had some good looks. It didn't go down. I think we were fortunate to play them when Armand Franklin was coming off the injury. You play him in a week, he makes two or three of those threes, if not more. He got some pretty good looks at the basket. I thought our defense was just okay tonight. They had some shots around the rim not go down. They had free throws that didn't go down. Race Thompson and Trace Jackson Davis both missed a lot of free throws. It's a different game. I know Travion missed his free throws too, so you can kind of use that as a wash to a degree. But, we had some things go our way. And tonight, I think we made our own breaks with our ability to shoot and execute on the offensive end. But defensively, we were just okay. And if your offense is good enough to get you to 80 on the road, which last game we scored 55 points, on the road, then, so be it. But we have to do a better job defensively.
Your two freshman guards, Jaden gets like 13 on like four shots and Ethan makes that big three. Can you just speak to them being kind of ready for the moment?
Yeah, it was great for Ethan. Ethan's been a guy that, has struggled, has mono and has fought through a lot of things and hasn't got consistent minutes. So it was great for him. He's worked very hard. He's going to be a great player at Purdue. Jaden's going to be a great player. And Jaden, he really gave us a spark tonight. And being able to beat his man off the dribble and be a threat. Obviously, he knocked down some shots to go with it, but he got a couple key rebounds. And then Brandon, makes his free throws down the stretch, gets a couple rebounds for us down the stretch. That was very good. I thought Mason had some hustle plays, that we really benefited from it. Zach didn't get going tonight, but, Zach causes issues. They have to help down there. They have to give a lot of attention to him when he's in the game because he's tough to guard one-on-one.
Good. Thanks, Matt.
Thank you.
Mike.
Yeah, Matt, you talked about practicing getting ready to shoot. Do you believe that led to what you guys did from the three-point line tonight?
I think in some of them it did. There's some things that are opportunistic, that just kind of happen, whether it's like a ball reversal or somebody overhelps, and all of a sudden you just find yourself open. And then you got to step into it. There's other things that you run that you got a good chance of getting a shot, from that action. So I think it was a combination, of a lot of things. But, yeah, you have to get yourself ready. A lot of times shots are made or missed, before what you do, before you catch the basketball. And we really discussed that. When you go 3 for 24, as long as you feel comfortable with the people that are shooting them, sometimes you don't like the shots every now and then. But as long as you feel comfortable with the people, you just got to work through it. And we have a lot of guys that can shoot the basketball when they're set. So we felt good about it. And we were just hoping that the numbers, you know, swayed in the other direction, and they did.
This has been a season of curveballs because of COVID and all that. And you found yourself on a four-game road trip, unexpected, but you still find yourself on a four-game road trip. To get out of this 2-2, what can that mean for this team?
Right. Well, just, you know, going back home, you're not guaranteed you're going to win. You know, it's that piece of it starts it because your next game's at the home, and then we go back and play, you know, another road game and go 5 out of 6, you know, on the road. And that's a rescheduled COVID game. And so even though it wasn't the actual team, but that they had to arrange some things. And so, you know, now we have a 1-day prep after Sunday. So it's just part of, no matter who you are, you know, you're going to have it be tough for you at some time. And just, you know, make the most of it. Don't make excuses. Try to find the silver lining when it doesn't go your way. And, you know, just keep working. But, you know, we knew things of this nature were going to happen.
You guys on the road recently have played from behind. Today you're playing from ahead. And when Indiana cuts into the lead, you're starting to turn the ball over a little bit more. What allowed, was that more of a composure thing that maybe you've learned from some of these road games that maybe kicked in?
Well, obviously Indiana picked up, you know, their pressure there, you know, in the first half, in the second half. And, you know, we had some guys just, you know, slinging it and just not handling pressure, taking care of the basketball, you know, stepping off and getting a catch for your teammate, things of that nature. And just, you know, we lost our composure. So I don't know if you want to put that on us or give credit to Indiana, probably a little bit of both. But when we did, you know, start to execute and handle their pressure, I thought we did some, you know, I thought we did some good things there. But they, there's no doubt they gave us some trouble when they got after us.
Thank you.
Yep.
Anyone else, Coach Painter?
Yeah, Coach, 8 straight in this rivalry for the first time since somewhere around the 1930s. I know those are just numbers, but what do wins like these do for you and your program moving forward in a wild season?
Yeah, just, you know, just beating a good team on the road, you know, besides, you know, a rivalry game or winning 8 straight or whatever the stat is, you know, just, you know, having a young team and being able to build some confidence with a road win. You know, we won on neutral court. We won on the road against Michigan State, now being able to win here, just trying to, you know, build some confidence with your group and, just proud of them, you know, just, we're not perfect, obviously. And, but I thought we played hard and did some good things to, you know, today. And that's what we got to do is just keep getting better. We got a lot of games coming our way though. So, you know, this is what you kind of work for as a player. You kind of love it because, you know, I like the practices. I like being prepared when we play. But it's kind of part of it sometimes when you only have 1 day or 2 days to prepare. But players, I think, love that piece of it.
Anyone else?
Coach, the toughness your team showed tonight, you know, you managed to keep Trace off the boards a little bit. I know he had 25, but just kind of the ability to kind of control that area a little bit, and obviously Travion doing some things as well.
Yeah, well, I thought Travion did some good things offensively in the second half. You know, he was, I thought, you know, pretty dominating. He got some good rebounds. Obviously, he had 10 rebounds in the game. You know, Trace Jackson Davis is a tough matchup. He's a good player. He's a very good player. And to kind of have like a pseudo off game and still score 25 points just shows you how good he is. And, you know, I don't, you know, he missed his free throws. You know, think about it. He's 7-for-14 from the line. I don't know how many of those are front ends. But, like, you know, he makes his free throws. You're talking about a guy who's 30 points. And it's probably, you know, pretty close game, you know, possession game, you know, at the end there. And so, you know, but he's really good, man. He's I thought a couple times, you know, we got him to miss. I thought a couple times he just missed. And we just allowed him too much freedom. You just can't let him freelance like that. When he freelances like that, his combination of his strength and his athleticism and his mobility, you know, was too much for us at times, but we got to do a better job before he gets the basketball and be in better guarding position. But give credit to him. He's a tough cover.
Coach, your double teams in the post in the last 10 minutes seemed to be really impactful. Were you guys doing anything different there?
No, I thought they were in different positions. You know, they got the ball underneath the block a couple times. You know, when you can get the ball from the top, I thought we did a poor job of letting the ball come in from the top. I think it was the guy guarding him and the other guy that we had sagging off from the other big normally. And we just allowed the ball to get in there too much. And when they did, you know, they made the most of it. But I thought as the game progressed, they were a little bit lower. We didn't allow the ball from the top as much. And then when it did go in, we were quicker on our doubles. You know, just little things, you know, having four high hands up, being there on the catch, not letting them turn their shoulder, and other guys zoning off and just really talking and bottle. You know, part of what we do, we know there's risk to it. We do it with everybody. Most of them, I should say all the time, but most of the time we do it. We're a post-double team. But there is a downside to it. If you're late or you're not quick or, if you don't limit their vision, they're just going to pick you apart. And so I thought as the game progressed, we did a better job in those areas.
Is that it? Cool. Thank you, guys.